Snoop Dogg. Calvin Cordozar Broadus Jr., born October 20, 1971, known professionally as Snoop Dogg, is an American rapper, singer, songwriter, producer, media personality, entrepreneur, and actor. His music career began in 1992 when he was discovered by Dr. Dre and featured on Dre's solo debut, Deep Cover, and then on Dre's solo debut album, The Chronic. He has since sold over 23 million albums in the United States and 35 million albums worldwide. Snoop's debut album, Doggy Style, produced by Dr. Dre, was released in 1993 by Death Row Records. Bolstered by excitement driven by Snoop's featuring on The Chronic, the album debuted at number one on both the Billboard 200 and Billboard Top R&B/Hip-Hop Albums charts. Selling almost a million copies in the first week of its release, Doggy Style became certified quadruple platinum in 1994 and spawned several hit singles, including What's My Name, and Gin and Juice. In 1994, Snoop released a soundtrack on Death Row Records for the short film Murder Was the Case, starring himself. His second album, Tha Dog Father, 1996, also debuted at number one on both charts, with Snoop's Upside Your Head as the lead single. The album was certified double platinum in 1997. After leaving Death Row Records, Snoop signed with No Limit Records, where he recorded his next three albums, Da Game Is To Be Sold, Not To Be Told, 1998, No Limit Top Dog, 1999, and Tha Last Meal, 2000. Snoop then signed with Priority/Capital/Emmy Records in 2002, where he released Paid Tha Cost To Beat A Boss. He then signed with Geffen Records in 2004 for his next three albums, R&G, Rhythm and Gangsta The Masterpiece, Tha Blue Carpet Treatment, and Ego Trippin'. Malice and Wonderland, 2009, and Dogumentary, 2011, were released on Priority. Snoop Dogg has starred in motion pictures and hosted several television shows, including Doggy Fizzle Televizzle, Snoop Dogg's Fatherhood, and Dog After Dark. He also coaches a youth football league and high school football team. In September 2009, Snoop was hired by Emmy as the chairman of a reactivated Priority Records. In 2012, after a trip to Jamaica, Snoop announced a conversion to Rastafarianism and a new alias, Snoop Lion. As Snoop Lion, he released a reggae album, Reincarnated, and a documentary film of the same name, about his Jamaican experience, in early 2013. His 13th studio album, Bush, was released in May 2015 and marked a return of the Snoop Dogg name. His 14th solo studio album, Collade, was released in July 2016. Snoop has 17 Grammy nominations without a win. In March 2016, the night before WrestleMania 32 in Arlington, Texas, he was inducted into the celebrity wing of the WWE Hall of Fame, having made several appearances for the company, including as Master of Ceremonies during a match at WrestleMania XXIV. In 2018, he released his first gospel album, Bible of Love. On November 19, 2018, Snoop Dogg was given a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. Early life. Calvin Cordozar Broadus Jr. was born in Long Beach, California, the second of three sons. He was named after his stepfather, Calvin Cordozar Broadus Sr. His mother is Beverly Broadus, née Tate. His father, Vernel Varnado, was a Vietnam veteran, singer, and mail carrier who was frequently absent from his life. As a boy, Broadus's parents nicknamed him Snoopy because of his appearance and love of the cartoon character from Peanuts, but usually addressed him as Calvin at home. His mother and stepfather divorced in 1975. When he was very young, Broadus began singing and playing piano at Golgotha Trinity Baptist Church. In sixth grade, he began rapping. Broadus's father left the family when he was 3 months old. A DNA test read by George Lopez on Lopez Tonight revealed Broadus to be of 71% African, 23% Native American, and 6% European descent. As a teenager, Broadus frequently ran into trouble with the law. He was a member of the Rollin' 20 Crips gang in the East Side area of Long Beach, although he stated in 1993 that he never joined a gang. Shortly after graduating from high school, he was arrested for possession of cocaine, and for the next 3 years was frequently in and out of jail or prison, including Wayside Jail. With his cousins Nate Dogg and Lil One Half Dead and friend Warren G, Snoop recorded homemade tapes as a group called 213, named after the Long Beach area code. One of his early solo freestyles Over and Vogue's Hold On made it to a mixtape that was heard by influential producer Dr. Dre, who called to invite him to an audition. Former N.W.A. associate the DOC taught him how to structure his lyrics and separate the thematics into verses, hooks, and chorus. Musical career. 1992-1998, Death Row, Doggy Style, and THA Dog Father. When he began recording, Broadus took the stage name Snoop Doggy Dog. Dr. Dre began working with Snoop Dogg, first on the theme song of the 1992 film Deep Cover, and then on Dr. Dre's debut solo album The Chronic with the other members of his former starting group, THA Dog Pound. The huge success of Snoop Dogg's debut Doggy Style was partially because of this intense exposure. Fueling the ascendance of West Coast G-Funk hip-hop, the singles Who Am I, What's My Name, and Gin and Juice reached the top 10 most played songs in the United States, and the album stayed on the Billboard charts for several months. Gangsta rap became the center of arguments about censorship and labeling, with Snoop Dogg often used as an example of violent and misogynistic musicians. Unlike much of the harder-edged gangsta rap artists, Snoop Dogg seemed to show his softer side, according to music journalist Chuck Phillips. Rolling Stone music critic Turi asserted that Snoop had a relatively soft vocal delivery compared to other rappers. Snoop's vocal style is part of what distinguishes him, where many rappers scream, figuratively and literally, he speaks softly. Doggy Style, much like The Chronic, featured a host of rappers signed to or affiliated with the Death Row label including Daz Dillinger, Corrupt, Nate Dogg, and others. A short film about Snoop Dogg's murder trial, Murder Was the Case, was released in 1994, along with an accompanying soundtrack. On July 6, 1995, Doggy Style Records, Inc., a record label founded by Snoop Dogg, was registered with the California Secretary of State as business entity number C1923139. Broadus was acquitted of his murder charge on February 20, 1996. According to Broadus, after he was acquitted he did not want to continue living the gangsta lifestyle, because he felt that continuing his behavior would result in his assassination or a prison term. After his acquittal, he, the mother of his son, and their kennel of 20 pit bulls moved into a 5,000 square foot, 460 square meters, home in the hills of Claremont, California, and by August 1996 Doggy Style Records, a subsidiary of Death Row Records, signed the Gap Band's Charlie Wilson as one of its first artists. He collaborated with fellow rap artist Tupac Shakur on the 1996 single Two of America's Most Wanted. This was one of Shakur's last songs while alive. He was shot on September 7, 1996, in Las Vegas, dying 6 days later. By the time Snoop Dogg's second album, THA Dog Father, was released in November 1996, the price of appearing to live the gangsta life had become very evident. Among the many notable hip-hop industry deaths and convictions were the death of Snoop Dogg's friend and label mate Tupac Shakur and the racketeering indictment of Death Row co-founder Shuge Knight. Dr. Dre had left Death Row earlier in 1996 because of a contract dispute, so Snoop Dogg co-produced THA Dog Father with Daz Dillinger and DJ Pooh. This album featured a distinct change of style from Doggy Style, and the lead-off single, Snoop's Upside Your Head, featured a collaboration with Charlie Wilson. The album sold reasonably well but was not as successful as its predecessor. THA Dog Father had a somewhat softer approach to the G-Funk style. After Dr. Dre withdrew from Death Row Records, Snoop realized that he was subject to an ironclad time-based contract, i.e., that Death Row practically owned anything he produced for a number of years, and refused to produce any more tracks for Suge Knight other than the insulting Fuck Death Row until his contract expired. In an interview with Neil Strauss in 1998, Snoop Dogg said that though he had been given lavish gifts by his former label, they had withheld his royalty payments. Stephen Thomas Erlewine of AllMusic said that after THA Dogg Father, Snoop Dogg began moving away from his gangsta roots toward a calmer lyrical aesthetic. For instance, Snoop participated in the 1997 Lollapalooza concert tour, which featured mainly alternative rock music. Troy J. Augusto of Variety noticed that Snoop's set at Lollapalooza attracted much dancing, and, strangely, even a small mosh pit in the audience. 1998-2006, signing with No Limit and continued success. Snoop signed with Master P's No Limit Records, distributed by Priority/Emmy Records, in March 1998 and debuted on the label with Da Game Is To Be Sold, Not To Be Told later that year. His other albums on No Limit were No Limit Top Dog in 1999, selling over 1,510,000 copies, and THA Last Meal in 2000, selling over 2,100,000. In 1999, his autobiography, THA Dogg Father, was published. In 2002, he released the album Paid THA Cost To Beat A Bo Dollar Dollar, on Priority/Capital/Emmy, selling over 1,310,000 copies. The album featured the hit singles from THA Chich To Da Palace and Beautiful, featuring guest vocals by Ferrell. By this stage in his career, Snoop Dogg had left behind his gangster image and embraced a pimp image. In June 2004, Snoop signed to Geffen Records/Star Track Entertainment, both distributed by Interscope Records. Star Track is headed by producer duo The Neptunes, which produced several tracks for Snoop's 2004 release R&G, Rhythm and Gangsta The Masterpiece. Drop It Like It's Hot, featuring Ferrell, the first single released from the album, was a hit and became Snoop Dogg's first single to reach number one. His third release was Signs, featuring Justin Timberlake and Charlie Wilson, which entered the UK chart at number two. This was his highest entry ever in the UK chart. The album sold 1,730,000 copies in the US alone, and most of its singles were heavily played on radio and television. Snoop Dogg joined Warren G and Nate Dogg to form the group 213 and released The Hard Way in 2004. Debuting at number 4 on the Billboard 200 and number 1 on the top R&B/hip-hop albums, it included the single Groupie Love. Snoop Dogg appeared in the music video for Korn's Twisted Transistor along with fellow rappers Lil Jon, Xzibit, and David Banner. Snoop Dogg appeared on two tracks from Ice Cube's 2006 album Laugh Now, Cry Later, including Go to Church, and on several tracks on THA Dogg Pound's Cali Is Active the same year. His song Real Talk was leaked on the internet in the summer of 2006 and a video was later released on the internet. Real Talk was dedicated to former Crips leader Stanley Tookie Williams and a diss to Arnold Schwarzenegger, the governor of California. Two other singles on which Snoop made a guest performance were Keep Bouncing by Too Short, also with Will.i.am of the Black Eyed Peas, and Gangsta Walk by Coolio. Snoop's 2006 album THA Blue Carpet Treatment debuted on the Billboard 200 at number 5 and sold over 850,000 copies. The album and the second single That's That Shit featuring R. Kelly were well received by critics. In the album, he collaborated in a video with E-40 and other West Coast rappers on the single Candy, Drippin' Like Water. 2007-2012, Ego Trippin', Malice in Wonderland and Dogumentary. In July 2007, Snoop Dogg made history by becoming the first artist to release a track as a ringtone before its release as a single, It's the D.O.G. On July 7, 2007, Snoop Dogg performed at the Live Earth concert, Hamburg. Snoop Dogg has ventured into singing for Bollywood with his first ever rap for an Indian movie, Sing is King. The song title is also Sing is King. He appears in the movie as himself. The album featuring the song was released on June 8, 2008 on Jung Lee Music Records. He released his ninth studio album, Ego Trippin', selling 400,000 copies in the US, along with the first single, Sexual Eruption. The single peaked at number 7 on the Billboard 100, featuring Snoop using autotune. The album featured production from QDT, Quick Dog Teddy. Snoop was appointed an executive position at Priority Records. His 10th studio album, Malice in Wonderland, was released on December 8, 2009. The first single from the album, Gangsta Love, featuring The Dream, peaked at number 35 on the Billboard Hot 100. The album debuted at number 23 on the Billboard 200, selling 61,000 copies its first week, making it his lowest charting album. His third single, I Wanna Rock, peaked at number 41 on the Billboard Hot 100. The fourth single from Malice in Wonderland, titled Pronto, featuring Soulja Boy Tell Em, was released on iTunes on December 1, 2009. Snoop re-released the album under the name More Malice. Snoop collaborated with Katy Perry on California Girls, the first single from her album Teenage Dream, which was released on May 11, 2010. Snoop can also be heard on the track Flashing by Dr. Dre and on Current Dollar Y's song Seat Change. He was also featured on a new single from Australian singer Jessica Mauboy, titled Get Em Girls, released September 2010. Snoop's latest effort was backing American recording artist, MEI, on her second single entitled Mr. Romeo, released October 26, 2010 as a follow-up to Magic. Snoop also collaborated with American comedy troupe The Lonely Island in their song Turtleneck and Chain, in their 2011 album Turtleneck and Chain. Snoop Dogg's 11th studio album is Dogumentary. The album went through several tentative titles including Doggy Style 2, DHA Dogumentary and Dogumentary Music, 0020 before being released under the final title Dogumentary during March 2011. Snoop was featured on Gorilla's album Plastic Beach on a track called Welcome to the World of the Plastic Beach with the Hypnotic Brass Ensemble. He also completed another track with them entitled Something Like This Night, which does not appear on Plastic Beach, yet does appear on Dogumentary. He also appears on the latest Tech N9NE album All Sixes and Sevens, released June 7, 2011, on a track called Pornographic, which also features E40 and Chris Calico. 2012-2013, Reincarnated and 7 Days of Funk. On February 4, 2012, Snoop Dogg announced a documentary, Reincarnated, alongside his new upcoming studio album entitled Reincarnated. The film was released March 21, 2013 with the album slated for release April 23, 2013. On July 20, 2012, Snoop Dogg released a new reggae single, La La La, under the pseudonym Snoop Lion. Three other songs were also announced to be on the album, No Guns Allowed, Ashtrays and Heartbreaks, and Harder Times. On July 31, 2012, Snoop introduced a new stage name, Snoop Lion. He told reporters that he was rechristened Snoop Lion by a Rastafarian priest in Jamaica. In response to Frank Ocean coming out, Snoop said hip-hop was ready to accept a gay rapper. Snoop recorded an original song for the 2012 fighting game Tekken Tag Tournament 2, titled Na-C-M Down, and makes a special appearance as a non-playable character in the Snoop Dogg stage arena. In September of the same year, Snoop released a compilation of electronic music entitled Loose Joints under the moniker DJ Snoopadelic, stating the influence of George Clinton's Funkadelic. In an interview with the Fader magazine, Snoop stated Snoop Lion, Snoop Dogg, DJ Snoopadelic, they only know one thing, make music that's timeless and bangs. In December 2012, Snoop released his second single from Reincarnated, Here Comes the King. It was also announced that Snoop worked a deal with RCA Records to release Reincarnated in early 2013. Also in December 2012, Snoop Dogg released a That's My Work, a collaboration rap mixtape with THA Dogg Pound. In an interview with Hip Hop Weekly on June 17, producer Symbolic One, S1, announced that Snoop was working on his final album under his rap moniker Snoop Dogg. I've been working with Snoop, he's actually working on his last solo album as Snoop Dogg. In September 2013, Snoop released a collaboration album with his sons Stha Broadus Boys titled Royal Fam. On October 28, 2013, Snoop Dogg released another mixtape entitled That's My Work 2, hosted by DJ Drama. Snoop formed a funk duo with musician Damn Funk called 7 Days of Funk and released their eponymous debut album on December 10, 2013. 2014-2017, Bush, Khalid, and Neva left. In August 2014, a clip surfaced online featuring a sneak preview of a song Snoop had recorded for Pharrell. Snoop's Pharrell Williams-produced album Bush was released on May 12, 2015, with the first single Peaches and Cream having been released on March 10, 2015. On June 13, 2016, Snoop Dogg announced the release date for his album Khalid, which was released on July 1, 2016. He headlined a unity party for donors at Philly's Electric Factory on July 28, 2016, the last day of the Democratic National Convention. Released March 1, 2017 through his own Doggy Style Records, Promise You This precedes the release of his upcoming Khalid film based on the album of the same name. Snoop Dogg released his 15th studio album Neva Left in May 2017. 2018, Bible of Love. He released a gospel album titled Bible of Love on March 16, 2018. Snoop was featured on Gorilla's latest album The Now Now on a track called Hollywood with Jamie Principle. In November 2018, Snoop Dogg announced plans for his Puff Puff Pass tour, which features Bone Thugs and Harmony, Too Short, Warren G, Corrupt, and others. The tour ran from November 24 to January 5. Snoop Dogg was featured on Lil Dicky's April 2019 single Earth, where he played the role of a marijuana plant in both the song's lyrics and animated video. On June 25, 2019, The New York Times Magazine listed Snoop Dogg among hundreds of artists whose material was reportedly destroyed in the 2008 Universal fire. 2019, I Wanna Thank Me and Collaborations. On July 3, 2019, Snoop Dogg released the title track from his upcoming 17th studio album, I Wanna Thank Me. The album is expected to drop in the summer 2019. Snoop Dogg collaborated with Vietnamese singer Sun Tung MTP in Hey Trho Cho On, Give It To Me, which was officially released on July 1, 2019. As of July 17, 2019, the music video has amassed 100,341,914 views on YouTube. Other ventures. Snoop Dogg has appeared in numerous films and television episodes throughout his career. His starring roles in film includes The Wash, with Dr. Dre, and the horror film Bones. He also co-starred with rapper Wiz Khalifa in the 2012 movie Mac and Devin Go to High School, which a sequel has been announced. He has had various supporting and cameo roles in film, including Half-Baked, Training Day, Starsky and Hutch, and Bruno. He has starred in 3 television programs, sketch comedy show Doggy Fizzle Televizzle, variety show Dog After Dark, and reality show Snoop Dogg's Fatherhood, also starring Snoop's wife and children. He has starred in episodes of King of the Hill, Las Vegas, and Monk, 1 episode of Robot Chicken, as well as 3 episodes of One Life to Live. He has participated in 3 Comedy Central roasts, for Flavor Flav, Donald Trump, and Justin Bieber. Cameo television appearances include episodes of The L Word, Weeds, Entourage, I Get That A Lot, and The Price Is Right. He has also appeared in an episode of the YouTube video series, Epic Rap Battles of History as Moses. In 2000, Snoop, as Michael J. Corleone, directed Snoop Dogg's Doggy Style, a pornographic film produced by Hustler. The film, combining hip-hop with X-rated material, was a huge success and won top-selling release of the year at the 2002 Avenue Awards. Snoop then directed Snoop Dogg's Hustlers, Diary of a Pimp in 2002, using the nickname Snoop Scorsese. Snoop founded his own production company, Snoopadelic Films, in 2005. Their debut film was Boss N Up, a film inspired by Snoop Dogg's album R&G, starring Lil Jon and Trina. On March 30, 2008, he appeared at WrestleMania XXIV as a master of ceremonies for a tag team match between Maria and Ashley Massaro as they took on Beth Phoenix and Melina. In December 2013, Snoop performed at the annual Kennedy Center Honors Concert, honoring jazz pianist Herbie Hancock. After his performance, Snoop credited Hancock with inventing hip-hop. On several occasions, Snoop has appeared at the Players Ball in support of Bishop Don Magic Juan. Juan appeared on Snoop's videos for Boss Playa, A.D.I.D.A.C, P.I.M.P., Remix, Nothing Without Me and A Pimp's Christmas Song. In November 2015, he starred in an Old Navy TV commercial together with Kumail Nanjiani and Julia Louis-Dreyfus. In January 2016, a Change.org petition was created in the hopes of having Dogg narrate the entire Planet Earth series. The petition comes after Snoop narrated a number of nature clips on Jimmy Kimmel Live. In April 2016, Snoop Dogg performed Straight Outta Compton and Fuck DHA Police at Coachella, during a reunion of NWA members Dr. Dre, Ice Cube, and MC Ren. He hosted a basketball fundraiser Hoops for Water for Flint, Michigan. The event occurred on May 21, 2016 and was run by former Toronto Raptors star and Flint native Morris Peterson. In the fall of 2016, VH1 premiered a new show featuring Snoop Dogg and his friend Martha Stewart called Martha and Snoop's Potluck Dinner Party, featuring games, recipes, and musical guests. Snoop Dogg and Stewart also later starred together in a Super Bowl commercial for T-Mobile during Super Bowl Lee in February 2017. Snoop currently hosts a revival of The Joker's Wild, which spent its first two seasons on TBS before moving to TNT in January 2019. Style and rap skills. Cool Mo D ranks Snoop at number 33 in his book There's a God on the Mic, and says he has an ultra-smooth, laid-back delivery and flavor-filled melodic rhyming. Peter Shapiro describes Snoop's delivery as a molasses drawl and all music notes his drawled, laconic rhyming style. Cool Mo D refers to Snoop's use of vocabulary, saying he keeps it real simple, he simplifies it and he's effective in his simplicity. Snoop is known to freestyle some of his lyrics on the spot for some songs in the book How to Rap. Lady of Rage says, Snoop Dogg, when I worked with him earlier in his career, that's how created his stuff, he would freestyle, he wasn't a writer then, he was a freestyler, and the DOC states, Snoop's was a one-take willy, but his shit was all freestyle. He hadn't written nothing down. He just came in and started busting. The song was THA Shiznit that was all freestyle. He started busting and when we got to the break, Dre cut the machine off, did the chorus and told Snoop to come back in. He did that throughout the record. That's when Snoop was in the zone then. Peter Shapiro says that Snoop debuted on Deep Cover with a shockingly original flow which sounded like a slick Rick born in South Carolina instead of South London and adds that he showed where his style came from by covering Slick Rick's La Dida Dee. Referring to Snoop's flow, Cool Mo D calls him one of the smoothest, funkiest flowers in the game. How to Rap also notes that Snoop is known to use syncopation in his flow to give it a laid-back quality, as well as linking with rhythm in his compound rhymes, using alliteration, and employing a sparse flow with good use of pauses. Snoop repopularized the use of Izzle speak, particularly in the pop and hip-hop music industry. Personal life. Snoop married his high school sweetheart, Shantae Taylor, on June 12, 1997. On May 21, 2004, he filed for divorce from Taylor, citing irreconcilable differences. The couple renewed their wedding vows on January 12, 2008. They have three children together, sons Cord, born August 21, 1994, and Cordell, born February 21, 1997, who quit football to pursue a career as a filmmaker, and daughter Corey, born June 22, 1999. Snoop also has a son from a relationship with Lori Holmond, Julian Corey Broadus, born 1998. He is a first cousin of R&B singers Brandy and Ray J, and WWE professional wrestler Sasha Banks. In 2015, Snoop became a grandfather, as his eldest son, Cord Broadus, had a son with his girlfriend, Jessica Kaiser. Since the start of his career, Snoop has been an avowed cannabis smoker, making it one of the trademarks of his image. In 2002, he announced he was giving up cannabis for good. That did not last long, a situation famously referenced in the 2004 Adam Sandler movie 50 First Dates, and in 2013, he claimed to be smoking approximately 80 cannabis blunts a day. He has been certified for medical cannabis in California to treat migraines since at least 2007. Snoop claimed in a 2006 interview with Rolling Stone magazine that unlike other hip-hop artists who had superficially adopted the pimp persona, he was an actual professional pimp in 2003 and 2004, saying, "That shit was my natural calling and once I got involved with it, it became fun. It was like shooting layups for me. I was making M every time." He went on to say that on the advice of some of the pimps he knew, he eventually gave up pimping to spend more time with his family. Sports. Snoop is an avid sports fan, including hometown teams Los Angeles Dodgers, Los Angeles Lakers, and USC Trojans, as well as the Pittsburgh Steelers. He has stated that he began following the Steelers in the 1970s while watching the team with his grandfather. He is also a fan of the Oakland Raiders, Los Angeles Rams, and Dallas Cowboys, often wearing a number 5 jersey, and has been seen at Raiders training camps. He has shown affection for the New England Patriots, having been seen performing at Gillette Stadium. He is an avid ice hockey fan, sporting jerseys from the NHL's Pittsburgh Penguins and the AL's Springfield Indians, now the Utica Comets, in his 1994 music video Gin and Juice. On his reality show Snoop Dogg's Fatherhood, Snoop and his family received hockey lessons from the Anaheim Ducks, then returned to the Honda Center to cheer on the Ducks against the Vancouver Canucks in the episode Snow in the Hood. Snoop is a certified football coach and has been head coach of his son Cordell's youth football teams and the John A. Rowland High School team. Cordell played wide receiver and defensive back at Bishop Gorman High School in Las Vegas, Nevada, and received football scholarship offers from Southern California, UCLA, Washington, Cal, Oregon State, Duke, and Notre Dame. Cordell committed and signed a letter of intent to play for UCLA on February 4, 2015. On August 14, 2015, UCLA announced that Cordell had left the UCLA football team to pursue other passions in his life. Religion. In 2009, it was reported that Snoop was a member of the Nation of Islam. On March 1, he made an appearance at the Nation of Islam's annual Savior's Day holiday, where he praised Minister Louis Farrakhan. Snoop said he was a member of the Nation, but declined to give the date on which he joined. He also donated $1,000 to the organization. Claiming to be born again in 2012, Snoop converted to the Rastafari movement, switched the focus of his music to reggae and changed his name to Snoop Lion after a trip to Jamaica. He released a reggae album, Reincarnated, saying, "I have always said I was Bob Marley reincarnated." In January 2013, he received criticism from members of the Rastafarian community in Jamaica, including reggae artist Bunny Wailer, for alleged failure to meet his commitments to the culture. Snoop later dismissed the claims, stating his beliefs were personal and not up for outside judgment. Wailer is credited for giving Snoop the name Lion. Charity. Dog partners with city officials and annually gives away turkeys to the less fortunate in Inglewood, California at Thanksgiving. He gave away 3,000 turkeys in 2016. Politics. In 2012, Snoop Dogg endorsed Representative Ron Paul in the Republican presidential primary, but later said he would vote for Barack Obama in the general election, and on Instagram gave 10 reasons to vote for Obama, including he a black nigga, he's BFFs with Jay-Z, and Michelle got a fat ass, and 10 reasons not to vote for Mitt Romney, including he a white nigga, that motherfucker's name is Mitt, and he a hoe. In a 2013 interview with the Huffington Post, Snoop Dogg came out in support of same-sex marriage, saying, "People can do what they want." In his keynote address at the 2015 South by Southwest Music Festival, he blamed Los Angeles's explosion of gang violence in the 1980s on the economic policies of Ronald Reagan, and insinuated that his administration shipped guns and drugs into the area. He endorsed presidential candidate Hillary Clinton on Bravo's Watch What Happens Live in May 2015, saying, "I would love to see a woman in office because I feel like we're at that stage in life to where we need a perspective other than the male's train of thought, and just to have a woman speaking from a global perspective as far as representing America, I'd love to see that. So I'll be voting for Mrs. Clinton." Following the deadly shooting of 5 police officers in Dallas July 7, 2016, Snoop Dogg and the Game organized and led a peaceful march to the Los Angeles Police Department headquarters. The subsequent private meeting with the mayor Eric Garcetti and police chief Charlie Beck, and news conference was, according to Broadus, to get some dialogue and the communication going. The march and conference were part of an initiative called Operation H.U.N.T, serving as a police brutality protest in response to the police.